Hello dear students, welcome back to Quest Academy. In today's session, we shall be discussing about the transitive and intransitive verbs. So let's begin. Before understanding what are transitive and intransitive verbs are, we will first revise the concepts which we have learnt earlier. Subject, object and verb. We will understand these concepts with the help of examples. Bruno digs the ground. In this sentence, we are talking about Bruno, so Bruno is the subject. Digs is an action word, so it is a verb. And the ground, what is Bruno digging? He is digging the ground. So the word the ground is the object. We will see one more example. Sarah kicks the ball. In this sentence, we are talking about Sarah. So, Sarah is the subject. Kicks is an action word, so it is a verb. And what is Sarah kicking? Sarah is kicking the ball. So, the ball is the object. Now, let us discuss about the kinds of verbs. Transitive verbs and intransitive verbs. So let us discuss about them in detail. Transitive verbs. Verbs that require objects to complete their meaning are called as transitive verbs. In simple words, we can say that the action done by the subject is transferred to the object. Now, objects can be of two types, direct object and indirect object. Direct object is a word or words that receive the action of the verb in a sentence. Indirect objects are the words that receive the action indirectly. Also, indirect objects occur before the direct object. Let us understand the concept of transitive verbs from the following sentences. Suhani received the prize. Dad painted my room pink. I gave him 100 rupees. In the above sentences, the verbs received, painted and gave need nouns like prize, my room and 100 rupees to complete their meaning. In the third sentence, the verb gave has two objects, him and 100 rupees. Him is the indirect object and 100 rupees is the direct object. Intransitive verbs. Verbs that do not require objects to complete their meaning are called as intransitive verbs. There are two types of intransitive verbs, verbs of action and verbs of being. Words like laugh, come, talk and play are verbs of action, while words like is, am, was, were are verbs of being. They tell us about the state of being of the noun. So let us understand the concept of intransitive verbs from the following sentences. The baby sleeps. Aditya laughs. The horse runs fast. Many buildings in Lucknow are old and beautiful. The driver's job is to drive safely. In the above sentences, the verbs do not need objects to complete their meaning. They make complete sense by themselves. Such verbs are called as intransitive verbs. Now let us do a small exercise to understand the concept of transitive and intransitive verbs clearly. Alice cleans her room every day. In this sentence, Alice is the subject, clean is the verb, and the action of cleaning is transferred to the room, so the object is room. So we can say that this is a transitive verb. The police caught the thief. Here, the subject is police. Caught is an action and the action is transferred to the thief. So, the thief is the object. So, we can say that this is also a transitive verb. The sun shines brightly. In this sentence, the subject is the sun, shines is the action, but the object is missing. So, this is an intransitive verb. The hunter killed the tiger. The hunter is the subject, killed is the verb, and the tiger is the object. The action is getting transferred to the object, the tiger, so this becomes a transitive verb. My school begins at 8 o'clock in the morning. In this sentence, the school, my school, is the subject, begins is the action. But the object is missing in this sentence, so we can say that this is an intransitive verb. I hope this session was helpful to you children. Until next time, goodbye.